Hi everyone, this is Mike at BrashMonkey, and today's quick tip tutorial is about starting a Spriter project from scratch. Now the first thing I usually do when creating artwork that I'll be animating in Spriter is to just quickly sketch out the overall character or object in sort of a default or idle position. And one thing I recommend, of course it's not necessary, but there are some definite benefits to it, is to actually work about what I do is work 4 times the size of the actual resolution I need. And I do this because it allows me to work very quickly and sort of broadly and a little sloppier than if I were working at actual size, where I really would have to pay attention to almost every pixel very carefully. If you work really large, then when it gets reduced, it really sort of automatically cleans up your work quite a bit. The other nice thing about working at a larger size is that if it turns out you end up needing larger versions of the artwork or animations for a higher resolution version of the game later, or for just marketing art, you've already done the vast majority, if not all, of the work for that. Now once you have your object or character fully sketched out, it's the right size and the right general design, the next thing you're going to want to do is to start sort of cutting him up into individual body parts that you're going to need to sort of reassemble in Spriter so that they can each independently be moved and rotated and stretched. And once you cut up your character or object into different pieces, what I do, and it will be explained in another video that I will link to in the description of this video, I rotate them so they're all sort of lying flat and sort of facing to the right, as you can see here. So here's all of the separate parts of this crab character that I'll need to animate. And I rotated them before I started cleaning them up. And then all I need to do is just sort of trim them, just crop them all as separate images and save them out into a folder. And as you might see in the other video that I'll be linking to, you might not necessarily, in fact you most likely don't need to do this process of rotating the pieces before you clean them up, but you'll see in the other video why I tend to do it. It just gives you more animating freedom down the line. Now once you save out all of your individual body parts as 24-bit PNG images with transparent backgrounds, you're going to end up with a folder that looks something like this. However, you'll see this folder already has a Spriter file in this temporary file because I already have made the Spriter file, and because I have it open in Spriter, there's this file here. But aside from that, you'll have an image folder with your different body part images in it. Now what you can do before you get into Spriter, if you really have a lot of different parts going on, it might be worth your while to sort of divide your images into subfolders. So maybe I have a folder called head, a folder called legs, a folder called claws, for instance. That can make it easier to sort of stay organized in Spriter and to find your specific body part images more quickly. And don't forget, you can actually, you don't have to get to a perfectly cleaned up state with all of your body part images, because of course you can load them back into an image editor at any time, clean them up or edit them, and then save them back and reload them into Spriter. So you're not forced to work with an unchangeable image. You can even leave them purposefully quite rough to save yourself some time to perfect your animations and make sure in general that the images are roughly what you need, and then clean them up when you're otherwise done or close to finished with the animations. But anyway, once all of the images are cut up and appropriately trimmed and all in the same, all in one main folder or in subfolders within one main folder, you're ready to start up Spriter. So when you start up Spriter, it's going to look something like this, and what you're going to want to do is choose File, and then New Project, and then it's telling you you need to choose a project folder for your new Spriter project, and you just navigate to that folder that you created that has all of your images or all of your subfolders with images in it. So in this case, that is called Crab Spriter. So I select that folder, and now you'll see all of my images are ready to start to use. And ready to start animating. But I won't be working on an animation in this video. What I'll be doing is linking in the description of the video to other tutorials that I've already made that can take you from where this video leaves off. And that's it. Thanks a lot for watching.